I'm going to thump the microphone. Tell me if you hear that. I thumped the microphone. Can she hear that? Just a moment. Hello and welcome to the CCLS Christmas service. We will be beginning shortly. Okay, just a second. One moment. Tell me if you can hear this. Welcome to the CCLS 2022 Christmas service. We will be beginning shortly. We're good. Okay. There is a delay. Okay. I'm going to mute again.
Thank you. Good morning. Thank you for coming. I know it's not quite 9 o'clock, but I thought we would go ahead and get started with our pre-service music. And so our first player for our pre-service is Tate Warren. He is playing on his violin. Oh, come, oh, we're thankful. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to Christ Community Lutheran School for joyful celebration in our Christmas worship service. It seems very appropriate that we have a snowy morning since this is the first day of winter according to the calendar. So I guess our weather today makes sense. There's some small consolation in that. I'm just not quite sure where yet. But we begin. God has come to us. God is with us. Emmanuel. The coming of God's promised Messiah had long been foretold by the prophets.
And the people waited for their Savior,
set them free
from the
sins and darkness which covered their lives. When would the light come? From where would the light come? And how would the light come? How could God fulfill his seemingly impossible promise to send the Savior to redeem all mankind?
But now our faith is evidence of things not seen, the substance of things hoped for.
Come, Lord Jesus.
The birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way. Mary and Joseph, a young couple from the city of Nazareth, were engaged to be married.
But Mary was found to be with child, and Joseph resolved to leave her. Just then, an angel of the Lord came to Joseph in a dream and said,
Joseph, do not fear to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus. He will save the people from their sins.
All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear us a son, and his name shall be called Emmanuel, which means God with us.
Small child in a land of a thousand, one small.
far different than anyone could have ever imagined. He chose a young woman by the name of Mary to give birth to a child who he was sending to rescue and redeem his children.
The angel Gabriel greeted Mary. "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You are to bear a child, a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and be called the Son of the Most High." Mary was overwhelmed at the news. In amazement and wonder, she exclaimed, "How can this be?" The angel responded, "The power of the Most High will overshadow you, and the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God."
As Mary held the holy infant that first night, she worshipped and adored the new life God placed in her arms and heart.
The shepherds were the first to receive the news that night of the Holy Child's coming.
On a lonely Judean hillside, as they routinely watched their flocks, the shepherds were overwhelmed as they witnessed the dazzling host of angels telling the good news.
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger.
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests."
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks by night. The good news of Jesus' birth was given first to the shepherds, who lovingly cared for their sheep and protected the ones entrusted to them. In the same way, Jesus lovingly cares for us.
Oh, my God.
Come and see what God has done.
When they had seen him, the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen.
Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise.
O come, let us adore him.
Thank you.
Gift of God, Emmanuel, the holy love of God came down in Jesus Christ, bringing the joy of heaven to a dark world. This Christmas season, may we celebrate God's gift and share the joy of Christ with people everywhere.
Gift of God, God with us.
Come, let us adore him. Let us joyfully celebrate his birth. The Lord, this child of promise, has come.
Thank you. Well, good morning. Thank you all for giving up today on this blustery morning. I think most of you know that tonight's service is going to be canceled. If you are interested in showing this off to family and friends, there are links available to see this via our CCLS Facebook page and YouTube, and it's also available, I think, on St. Paul's Facebook page. So if you want to brag about your grandkids' performance today, you can share that, post that around to lots of people. That'd be wonderful. We are so blessed to have you here. I want to say thanks to our kids and to your children, to your grandchildren. Aren't they talented? What a way to witness their faith in a world that desperately needs them. We are in need of that so much. And so our ministry here is all about sharing Christ with kids and families, and today this is an example of that. I also want to just say hello. We've got a great teaching staff here, and they all worked hard to make this happen. But I would like to say hello to Brendan Cox, our music director. This is really her thing, and she's got fingers all over it, and she's so talented. And once a year, we get to really celebrate the work that she does. She's a gift for our school. So thank you, Brenda. On this crazy day, you may also know that we are closing school early today at 12:40. Having the weather that we have right now, if you were a parent here and you would like to, take your child and have one safe trip home right now when they're not here, we certainly understand that, okay? So if you want to do that, that's great. I would like to encourage everybody, though, because we've had to, crimp our Christmas celebration into one morning, to stick around, go down to the hallway, we've got lots of artwork celebrating our Christmas season. And if you'd like to stop in to a classroom and visit with your grandchild or the teacher, you are very welcome to do that. We'd love to have you do that today. Okay, go down and give those grandkids a hug and tell them that you're proud of them. It's wonderful. So once again, thanks for coming out. God's blessings on this Christmas season to you, and Merry Christmas to everybody. Thank you again. Thank you.